Hello, hello. Good morning, everybody. Can you hear me?
Yes, teacher. Good morning.
Kathy, good morning. How are you?
Hi, thank you. How about you?
I'm great. I'm good. Starting my day, Lupita, I think Lupita has some issues with the audio. All right, 9 o'clock right now. A beautiful morning as every day here in Acapulco, right? Today is Thursday, Pozolero. Jesus. We are going to sing today. All right, Jesus. Good morning, Jesus. Can you hear me?
Hello, teacher. Good morning.
How are you today? How are you today, Jesus?
Good
You
morning,
good?
teacher.
Good morning, Lupita. Now you're better. I see you were having problems with the computer. All right.
All right.
Can you see me, everybody?
Everybody.
Can you see me? Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. What are these?
This is a book.
No, what are these? Plural.
They are books.
They are books. Yes. What is this? Cola loca.
It is cola loca.
Yes, it's cola loca. It's glue. It's a glue.
It's a glue.
A glue, right. What is
Is sharpen.
sharpen? Sharpener.
Sharpen.
Sharpener.
Sharp
Sharp.
sharpener.
Three vowels. Sharpeners.
Sharpener.
What is this?
Engrapadura.
Use it to staple. To staple. Paper, right, ladies?
Paper. ¿Cómo dice que se llama?
Staple. Maybe it's a new word for you. This is a stapler. Stapler. Staple. So what, these ones, these are the staples. The little things. And this is stapler. Stapler.
Stapler.
I will send you the vocabulary. Well, we'll put it here in the board, the board. Stapler. Stapler. Staple. Stapler. Staple. Got it?
Paper.
Es diferente. It's different. Staple. You put it here.
Oh, yeah.
It's a little thing that is attached to the paper. And this is stapler. Got it? What is this?
Liquid paper.
Yes,
And
liquid
liquid
paper.
paper.
What do you use it for? ¿Para qué lo usan?
Para corregir.
Yes, same like this, right? What is this?
My eraser.
Right.
Eraser.
You use this? or you use this? Either one, right?
Okay.
What are these?
They are pens.
They are pens, okay. Yes. What is this?
Masking.
Yeah, tell me the correct answer, the whole answer. La respuesta correcta.
It's
a tape. It's called tape.
Tape.
T-A-P-E.
T-A-P-E.
You can write it on your notebook. T-A-P-E, tape. This is a tape. Okay, what are these little things you can write?
They are a post-it.
Notebook.
These are post-it.
It is nothing.
You were going to say, Alejandra, this is a, it is a, or they are?
It is.
Because it's plural. What are these?
They are. I don't see anything.
They are a post-it.
Post-it. Usually post-it is a brand. How we call them, right? Post-it, but they are called also sticky notes. Sticky because you there's some this part if it's sticky and you can stick it on the fridge or somewhere to remind something like doctor's appointment at 8, telephone bill, etc. Sticky. This is sticky and you can stick it.
Sticky.
You can stick it on the fridge or whatever, or anywhere. Sticky, sticky notes. That's why it's called stick, from the stick, right? What else do I have here? All right, what are these?
They are
notebooks.
Say it again. They are notebooks.
All right. Jesus, are you there? Well, everybody, I need you to participate and to answer. This is just an exercise from yesterday's class. So the point here is to answer not only the vocabulary, but the way, if I ask singular or plural, it's a notebook, they are notebooks, right? What is this? Singular, or what are these? Plural, right? What is this?
Oh, you sound good. Se dice,
it's a ruler.
It is ruler.
It's a ruler, right?
It's a ruler.
How many? No, that's gonna be not. Has centimeters? Centimeters for centimeters. From 1 to 30 centimeters. Right. All right, you must know this. You wear it every day. What is it? What is this?
It's a mask.
Yes.
It's a mask.
Good. Thank you for that's from yesterday's class. So let me write here today's class. So what day is today? ¿Qué día es hoy? What day is today?
It's Thursday, February.
Today. Lo voy a escribir completo, completo.
Today.
It's Thursday, right?
Thursday.
Thursday. Thursday. Thursday. 11, right?
Thursday.
Remember, after the number, you need to put TH. Es un número cardinal. Cardinal number. After the dates. Es primero, segundo, tercero. En inglés así es. Cuarto, quinto. So you need to put at the end, depending of the, on the number, like in this one, it's TH. 11th. 11th. 11th.
11th.
Right.
11th.
Please, si alguien no entiende algo de lo que hemos estado viendo, me lo tienen que dar a saber. Ok. Ya sea para que lo repasemos juntos o para que a uno individual, ya sea a través del chat de WhatsApp o personal, yo les pueda resolver su duda, pero no se queden con la duda. En inglés, nada es difícil si se busca la forma de entenderle y por qué esto o por qué el otro o cómo se pronuncia. Sobre todo la pronunciación es importante. Como les dije al principio, no se vayan con cargando un error lección tras lección, porque ese error se va convirtiendo en rutina, en costumbre, y lo dicen igual y lo dicen igual. So it's important you let me know whenever you make a, you have a question or you have a doubt about anything. So capish? Got it? Yes, right? Y aquí me salió acá arribita. Anyway, what the lesson is today? Lesson C, right? So yes. Estamos la unidad. We are in the unit 2.
2, lesson C.
Lesson C, because we have already lesson C. Sí. Okay, our learning objective. That's what it means, L-O. Learning. Quiere decir que es el objetivo de lo que vamos a aprender hoy, ¿verdad? Learning objective. Mm-hmm. Okay. We are going to learn things. Aquí nunca le encuentro esta computadora, chico. Es que es extranjera, italiana, y tiene cosas raras ahí. Pero bueno, learning objective is we are going to learn things in the classroom, right? Objects, items you have in the classroom. Okay, who remembers vocabulary? Things that you can find in the classroom. Picture, imagínenselo, porque como no estamos en un salón de clases, están en su casa. So remember vocabulary. What do you usually have in the classroom?
A desk.
A desk. What else?
A board.
Ok. Necesito que todos participen, lo que se acuerden. Es importante.
Chairs.
You said chairs.
Chairs.
Chairs, not chairs.
Chairs.
Chairs. Chairs.
Chairs.
Ajá.
A table.
Tables.
Computer.
Computer.
Clock. Okay.
A clock. Well, remember, a clock.
Window.
Well, window is part of the...
A window.
Yeah.
TV.
TV, yes. Remember to put a, well, a would keep it same, singular. Uh-huh. Plural, singular. You said a TV.
TV.
What else, Jesus?
A calendar.
A calendar, yes.
A map.
A map, yes.
A closet.
A closet, yeah, sometimes. Well, it depends on the classroom, mm-hmm. right?
So.
What is the word for projector in English?
It's the same. Well, not the same, but it's just like this. Hold on. In English, we say projector, ¿verdad? But we use a Y here. In English, it's projector. 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 Yes. Right.
Projector.
Mm-hmm. All right, anything else, Jesus, please?
TV player.
We can find a TV player, maybe. We already said TV.
TV. Mm-hmm.
A tape. Recorder.
A tape recorder.
Posters.
What did you say, Lupita?
Posters. Some.
Posters?
Sí, posters.
Oh, you said postcard.
Poster.
All right, so we have things, we already learned things we have in our backpack. Now things we have in the classroom, right? So this is more vocabulary for you. I don't know about Jesus. I think Jesus has some problems with the computer or with the Wi-Fi. But anyway, try to copy this vocabulary. Try to copy it or take a screenshot if you want. There are many words, many more words that you can find in a classroom. We're going to see the book right now and you will find more. So this is just a practice for you. Okay, before going to the next lesson, All right, we have it here. Can you see it? Can you see it? Yes. All right. So you will listen and say the words. You have to repeat after each one, right? Which things are in your classroom? Check the boxes. What else is in your classroom? Whatever you hear, you need to put a mark like this, like this, right? And you see also they have an A, right? A window, a TV, a closet, a map. It means they are singular, right? And for plurals, you see they use some. Some is more than one, meaning like a couple, three or four. Some posters, some scissors, some markers.
Some workbooks. Right?
Uh-huh.
Some it could chairs. Be
a couple, three, four. All right. Jesus is back. Let me play the audio for you. It's, I think it's page, what page is that? 14?
No, it's 16.
16.
16.
All right.
16.
You will listen to this, but pay attention to what I told you. Okay? When it's singular and when it's plural. All
right.
And you have the note here. Can you see it? Note a, an, and some. Remember a and an from yesterday? We use an with vowels, words that start with a vowel. And some is for plural. Use a and an with singular nouns. Use some with plural nouns. Right? Okay, listen.
Yes.
All right, hold on a second, please.
¿Qué quieres, mi cabello?
So how do you feel first, while mientras encuentro el audio, how do you feel about yesterday class? Do you have any questions? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta de la clase de ayer? Por ejemplo, este vocabulary from...
teacher.
Hi, Jesus. You're back. Jesus, we need to review lesson... you need to review lesson A and B.
Teacher.
Yes.
Yes, teacher. Tengo algunas dudas. Al rato se las mando por web personal.
Right. Yes. Yes.
Teacher, teacher.
Yeah, sí te escucho. Dime.
Is summer child or some child? Is summer child or some child?
Some chairs.
Some chairs.
Ajá, algunas sillas. Some chairs, no chair. Chairs.
Okay.
Some. En some, la palabra some no se pronuncia la E final. Some. Okay, here you go.
Okay. Child. Some change.
Some change. Some work. I do. And see again.
You see this one, the last one? Draw. Draw. Vamos a repasar. We're going to review each one pronunciation. ¿Sí me escuchan?
Sí.
Okay, you need to repeat. You repeat after me. A window.
A window.
Window.
A TV.
A TV.
Uh-huh. A closet.
A closet.
A map. Some posters.
Some scissors.
Some markers. A drawer.
Drawer.
What's the meaning of drawer?
Sounds like drawer. No W. No E. Drawer.
Door.
Right. Drawer. A waste basket. You see, this is a waste basket where you throw the garbage. This one, you see it?
A waste basket.
Uh-huh. You see here, some umbrellas.
Umbrellas?
Uh-huh, you see two, right? One, what color is this?
Umbrellas.
And this one? What color is this?
No se ve, profe.
No se ve.
Es que lo tengo en blanco y negro.
Oh. No. Okay. No, but you're seeing the computer, ¿no?
No, es que no se ve, o sea, se ve su pantalla, pero con los audios, no con el libro.
Oh, ¿no con el libro?
Okay, no. No.
You're supposed to see it. A ver, espérame. ¿Ya lo ven? No, cambia. Hold on. You're supposed to hear, to have the audios and the book at the same time. Okay, ¿ya lo ven?
Está compartiendo pantalla.
Yeah.
Better? Okay. Okay, you see some chairs here.
Some chairs.
A ver, let's see. Pronunciation chairs.
Chairs.
Chair.
Chairs.
Uh-huh. Sounds like.
Chairs.
And the other one, hold on. Oops. It's drawer. This one is like drawer. Es un poquito más lento con drawer. A table.
Well,
you have some tables here. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So it's some tables. A calendar, you see the calendar?
Calendar.
Mm-hmm. Calendar.
A clock. Remember a clock is the one that is on the wall. Es el que está en la pared, a clock.
A clock.
The one that you use on your wrist, in your hand, is a watch. That's what you wear on your arm.
Yes.
That's watch. That's watch. Not a clock. All right, so we have here a, an, and some. Did you see any with an? With the article an? There's no one, right?
And some.
No.
So we are now talking about the things we can find in a classroom. All right, look at the pictures. Look at the pictures. What things are in these places in the classroom above? On the wall.
On the wall.
So let me write something here for you. In this lesson, the purpose of this lesson, we're going to practice prepositions of place, right? Prepositions of place are like this, on, under, in, next to, in front of. Look at the positions of everything. Like on the wall, you see this one? There's a clock. On the floor. You will say on the floor. Está encima. Let's see. Uh-huh. On the floor. Under the chairs.
Under the chairs.
So here in this list you have to put every item, every object you see on the wall.
In the wall.
The same with the rest on the floor. You need to put it here. Continue with number 3, 4, 5, and 6.
Next to
you see the map and the calendar, the calendar and the window. So the calendar is next to the window, right? In front of the board. What is in front of the board?
The computer.
A computer.
Okay.
So you need to finish this. Whatever you see, put it here or here or here, number from 1 to 6. Es lo que van a ver, what you're going to see in the classroom. Let's say on the wall. What do you see on the wall? A clock, a A calendar. A
calendar.
So just put it there. Write it down. Póngalo, escríbanlo.
Yes.
Y ahorita lo leemos. Please. Jesus, are you there? Jesus, are you there? Can you hear me? We are working on this exercise B.
Including.
All right.
All right.
It's exercise B, number 1, 2, 3 until 6. Jesus, because
yes.
he wasn't here.
Teacher.
Yes. I can hear you. Tell me. Go ahead, Jesus. I'm listening. Finish the exercise. Whatever.
Finish.
Right. Preposition of place.
Teacher.
Yes.
What's the word for mochila in English?
Yeah, it's the one we saw yesterday. It's
a bag.
Backpack.
Is it what?
Yeah. No. Backpack. It's general. It's general. Bolsa.
That's...
Pero cuando ya quieres especificar qué tipo de bolsa, pues ya cada una tiene su nombre. Como si ves aquí en pantalla, puse backpack y tenemos y ahí también purse, que es el bolso de mano de normalmente usa lo que usa la mujer. Purse, backpack.
Okay.
Bag. We have plastic bag, right? Paper bag. De papel, etcétera.
Backpack.
Okay, finish.
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 All right. Number one on the wall. What do you see, Lupita? The wall.
One.
Number one.
A clock.
You have a clock. Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. A TV.
A TV. What else? Mm-hmm. What else?
Es calendar.
Say again, dilo otra vez.
A calendar.
A calendar. Anything else? ¿Algo más? All right, and number two on the floor. Alejandra.
The number two.
Mm-hmm.
Some umbrellas, a table, y a garter, bueno, basura.
A table, okay, what do you see? A table and what else?
A garter, bueno, basura, sí se dice así, ¿no? Garter.
A trash, ¿no?
A waste, you say a waste basket. Waste basket. Waste basket es una palabra compuesta, ¿verdad? Que waste es desperdicio. Waste, only this one, waste. And basket es el canasto. Un canasto para la basura.
Okay.
Weight basura. Ajá. This one. A weight basket.
A weight basket.
Ajá. All right. ¿Algo más? Anything else?
Solo eso. Bueno, solo alcancé a ver eso.
Yeah, you see.
Some chairs.
Some chairs on the floor. Well, chairs are on the floor. But you see here some books, some notebooks, some backpacks. Observen lo que hay detenidamente en el salón y lo que está en la pared, en el suelo, whatever. Right? So here we can say, what else? Some, remember when it's plural, some notebooks. What else? Some backpacks. All right, number three, Kathy.
Some backpacks, some books.
Yes.
It's all.
Yeah, they are under the chair, right? They are under the chair, but they are also on the floor, right?
Yes.
Okay. Jesus? Jesus, are you there? Jesús. Hello.
Yes.
Yes, ok.
Estoy contestando, permítame, por favor.
Ok.
Sorry, teacher.
No, it's okay. It's not your fault. It's your Wi-Fi or... Just answer number 4 in the closet. And we are going to use in. What do you see in the closet? So here you see in the closet. If you cannot speak, you can write it on the chat, Jesus, or you can do it on the chat on Zoom or on the chat in WhatsApp, either one. I mean, what I want you is to practice. I know we sometimes have problems with our Wi-Fi or whatever, so it's a little stressful, right? All right, so let's continue. Jesus, you have number 4. So va a estar pendiente. Jesus, number 4, number 5, he wants to do it. ¿Quién no quiere hacer? Volunteers. No se peleen, uno por uno. One by one.
Yo.
Next two. Yes, go ahead, please, Alejandra.
A calendar. A door and a closet.
A calendar, a door, a clock. Yes.
A door,
closet.
Okay. Kathy or Lupita, either one.
In front of the board. A computer. A table. A CD player.
A CD player. All right, I think that's enough. Just give me, let me show you a picture. Let me see if I can find it. So we are learning prepositions of place. So on means on top or something, like on the table, right? On the floor, not in the floor, not in the table. That's what it means on top. When we say in, means it's inside, like in the closet, right? In the house, adentro. In, right, next to.
Después.
Next to me, there's a chair next to me. No, junto a.
No.
Junto a, next to. Like the store, la miscelánea is next to my house. It's like, we usually say like this place is next door, but it's next door. Like the door is next to the wall, to the picture or to the just imagine picture what we are talking about. Let me show you more vocabulary for prepositions of place. I should have it here. Les estaré mandando más vocabulario, más hoy mismo, sobre esas preposiciones por WhatsApp, pero necesito que las chequen. Remember to check every information I send you. Cada información que les mando, necesito que las chequen. Son importantes, por eso se las mando, ¿verdad? Porque es parte de que ustedes adquieran esos conocimientos. Hoy nomás el gallo, ya amaneció. ¿A esta hora los gallos?
Mi vecina.
Oh.
Tiene un criadero de gallinas.
De gallinas, está bien para que despierten.
Bueno, sí, yo pero me despierto. No las comparto. Lo sí. Malo es que no las comparto.
¿Verdad? Un molito. Andale. No, a mí me despierta el de los bolillos. Bolillos toda la mañana. Qué feo. Y uno a dieta. All right, I have some pictures here. I hope you can see them. Okay, ¿pueden ver esta? Can you see this one?
Yeah.
It's a yellow picture and it's says on there. ¿Ven el gatito? No, es un gatito, un pajarito. Un gatito.
Sí.
It's on there. You see? On there. Vean la figura. Watch.
On there.
Look at the picture. On there.
Yeah.
Between, you see the little bird?
Between.
Entre. Out. Out, fuera.
Fuera.
Close to. Close to, it's very similar to next to. But close to is very, is close, that's why it's close to, pegado. Out, fuera. In, you see el gatito, the little cat? In, then it's inside. The cat is inside the box. Above, you see?
Por encima, ¿no? Sin tocar.
Encima, sin tocar esto, arriba.
Encima.
Ajá, behind.
Behind.
On, I explain on. On, in front on. Of.
In front of.
Uh-huh. Let me see, I have more here. Can you see this one? Can you see this picture?
Yes.
It's a green one, yeah. I have this one. Let's start from right to left. Right to left. Like on, in, at, right? So sometimes we use these prepositions of place in different ways, like on the way, on the radio, on the page, on a bicycle, on a ship, on a horse. Siempre usamos este on, no usamos in. Para in, please, escucho mucho ruido atrás de alguien, no sé de quién sea. Si pueden apagar el micrófono. In a taxi, a car, in the sky, in the building or tower, in a row, in the newspaper, in the garden. Son frases que siempre van con in, right? Not on the garden, in the garden. The same with at college, at home. Remember I told you at the beginning, no at the house, como normalmente algunos dicen, at the house, en la casa, no. Or in the house, no, at home. At reception, at school, at the bottom, at the cinema. Más adelante van a ir viendo poco a poco estas. Solamente se las quiero mostrar. Que sepan que existen, ¿verdad? Que hay más preposiciones de lugar. Let me see if you can see this one. Anyway, this, we'll send more information on WhatsApp about these prepositions. So it's extra vocabulary from the besides the book, but we must follow the book, right? ¿Sí lo ven? Can you see the book?
Aún no cargo. Bueno, ya cargo.
Ya. Yeah. All right. Okay, we're building language. That's page 17, I guess. Yes, 17. All right, just give me a second. Start checking the lesson from building vocabulary. So, vamos a hacerlo en pares. So, vayan checando el vocabulario, más bien la pronunciación de la lección. So, we're going to do it one by one, like with two people. Just give me a second. I just need to. We say 17, right? Okay, pay attention to the pronunciation. ¿Se escuchan?
Hello, I'm Mr. Kern.
No.
No, se oye muy bajito.
No, teacher, no.
Is the teacher's book, but where are the students' test papers?
They're in Ms. Moore's desk.
Oh, it's locked. Now, where's the key?
I don't know. Sorry.
Oh, well, no test today then. Oh, wait. It's right here in my coat pocket.
All right, listen one more time, please.
Teacher, repeat, please, the audio.
Listen one more time.
Page 17, 2, building language. A, listen, what is the teacher looking for? Hello, I'm Mr. Kern.
Hi, I'm Paula. Where's Ms. Moore?
She's sick today.
Oh, no. So, is the grammar test today?
Yes, it is. Okay, so this is the teacher's book, but where are the students' test papers?
They're in Ms. Moore's desk.
Oh, it's locked. Now, where's the key?
I don't know. Sorry.
Oh, well, no test today, then. Oh, wait. It's right here in my coat pocket.
All right, did you listen? Did you listen everything?
Yes. Yes.
All right, so. Let's pay attention now to the conversation, right? And pay attention to these questions. Hold on. Really? Awesome. Sometimes computers work like this, you know. Okay, can you see the book now? ¿Pueden ver el libro? Yes? All right. So we are going to practice Mr. Kern and Mr. Paula first, right? So, Katy, you are Mr. Kern. Alejandra, you are Paula.
Okay.
Okay. Hello, I'm Mr. Kern.
Hi, I'm Paula. Where's Ms. Moore?
She's sick today.
Oh, no. So, is the grammar test today?
Yes, it is. Okay, so this is the teacher book, but where are the students' test paper?
They read in Mr. Moore's desk.
Oh, it's locked. Now, where's the key?
I don't know, sorry.
Oh, well, not test today then. Oh, wait, it's right here in my coat pocket.
All right, so, let's change roles, just, it's locked. Locked. No lock it. Lock. Suena como una, no, no suena esta, la E, but sounds the D, locked.
Locked.
It's locked.
Okay.
Remember to use the right pronunciation in every word, but we are learning locked is the past tense of lock, right?
Yeah.
So que está bajo llave, locked. Now let's change Paula Alejandra. I mean, Mr. Kern is Alejandra, and vice versa.
Hello, I'm Mr. Kern.
Hi, I'm Paula. Where is Mr. Moore? Miss Moore?
She's sick today.
Oh no, so is the grammar test today?
Yes, it is. Oh, so this is the teacher's book, but where are the students' test paper?
They're in the Miss Moore desk.
Oh, it's, look, now, where's the key?
I don't know, sorry.
Oh, well, not this today then. Oh, wait, it's right here in the coat pocket.
All right, Miss, remember we talk about Mr. and Miss at the beginning. Mr. Mr. is solamente para hombres. Mr. and Miss. Here we sometimes use Miss or Miss or Misses. Right?
Right.
Remember, Miss es para una señorita que está casada. Mrs. is for a lady who is married. Mrs. usamos el apellido de ella. Miss igual. Y Miss es cuando no sabemos, es this one, no sabemos si es casada o es soltera. Right? That's the difference. Miss, señorita.
Miss.
Soltera. We know she's single. Mrs. casada. Con el apellido. Siempre es con el apellido. We always use the last name. And Miss, we don't know if she's single or married. So hay veces que para no errarle, como dicen, we use Miss, right?
Right. Miss.
All right. So in pronunciation, locked again.
Locked.
Yeah.
Lock.
Key. So hello, I'm Mr. Kern. Hi, I'm Paula. Oh, where's Miss Moore? She's sick today. Oh no. So is the grammar test today? Es una pregunta. So tiene que ir con la entonación de una pregunta. Yes, it is. Okay, so this is a teacher's. Aquí cuando lleve una S, tiene que ponerle énfasis. In English, you need to pronounce the S in a good way that it sounds like teacher's book.
Teacher's book.
Students' test papers.
Students' test paper.
Moore's desk.
Moore's desk.
Where's the key?
Where's the key?
Ajá, cuando vean la S, así tienen que recalcarle.
Where's
the
key? Okay. Lupita, you are Mr. Kern. And is it Katy, Alejandra, Lupita? Who else is here? Jesús? ¿Ya se fue Jesús?
No, teacher, estoy.
You're there, es que no te veo, chico. Jesús, you are, well, Jesús, you are Paula. Lupita, you're Mr. Kerr, and then you switch, you change roles.
Okay. Hello, I'm Mr. Kerr.
Hi, I am Paula. Oh, where Miss Moore?
Is she today?
Oh no. So is the grammar test today?
Is the grammar test today?
Grammar test today.
Repite. So is the grammar test today?
So is grammar. ¿Cómo?
So is the grammar test today?
Grammar test today.
All right, continue, Lupita.
Is the grammar test?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, it is. Okay, so this is the teacher book.
Teacher's book. Uh-huh.
But where are the students' test papers?
Il mismo desk.
Oh, it's look now where is the key?
Hold on. Oh, it's locked.
Now where's the key?
Right. Recuerda, aquí hay un punto. No puedes irte corridito.
Sí.
Oh, it's locked. Now, where's the key?
Where's the key?
Right. It's a question. Where's the key?
Where's the key?
Uh-huh. Paula. Jesus. I don't know. Sorry.
Oh, yes, teacher.
Say it again. Dilo otra vez.
I don't know. Sorry.
Yes.
No, sorry.
Ajá. Okay. Lupita.
Oh. Well, not this today, then. Oh, why? Is right here in my coat pocket.
Yeah. Oh wait.
It's right here in my coat pocket.
Coat pocket. All right. Uh-huh. All right. You change, Mr. Kern. Jesus.
Okay, I am Ms. Karen.
Hi, I am Paula. Ooh, where is Miss Moran?
She's sick today.
Oh no.
Sick today.
Oh. No. Sure. Is your grammar test today?
Okay. Yes, it is. Okay. So this is a teacher book. What are the student test papers?
Where are the students' test papers? Where are the students' test paper. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Continue. Ooh.
They are in Miss Morris' desk.
They're in Miss Moore's desk. Continue.
Now where's the key?
Where's the key?
Where's the key? Okay. Where's the key?
Siempre que vean contracción, usen la contracción, como que where's the key.
Okay.
Okay. Continue.
I don't know. Sorry.
Oh, why? No sé si hay. Oh, why? Is right. Era en mi.
Oh, well, not test today then. Okay, repite después de mí, Jesús. Oh, okay. Well, not oh, well. Test, not test today it then.
Not test today, nay.
Then.
Then.
Punto. Oh, wait.
Oh, wait.
It's right here.
It's right here.
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 Here. No suena here. La E, no suena la E final. Here.
Here.
In my coat pocket.
In my coat pocket.
So you see, son cuatro palabras. In my coat pocket.
In my coat pocket.
Coat, coat. Coat.
In my coat pocket.
No, no pronuncies que esto como L. Coat, una T, es una T, coat.
Coat, coat.
Coat, like C, como O, coat.
Coat, coat. Pocket.
Pocket, yes. Okay. So I want you to practice, cada lección que veamos, necesito que practiquen todos los días, like the building language. Es muy bueno para ustedes, para que se desarrollen y suelten un poquito su lengua en el idioma. Recuerden, hablar inglés no es lo mismo que hablar español. En el sentido de que uno, cuando empieza a hablarlo, se cansa más por cómo mueves tus gestos, tus labios, la lengua va aquí, la lengua va en diferente posición. Es lo mismo, nada más que como no estamos acostumbrados, al principio pues se va a hacer un poquito cansado, pero tienen que hacerlo. Si una oración, como por ejemplo el caso de Jesús, no te sale, ve palabra por palabra. Supongamos la última, it's hasta it's, que le salga. It's right, it's here.
Right here.
It's right here.
It's right here.
Ajá. In my coat pocket.
Coat
in
pocket.
My coat pocket.
In my coat.
In my coat pocket.
Coat.
In my coat.
No coat.
Coat.
Coat. Coat. Coat. Así, palabra por palabra, vayan checando desde el principio. Hello, I'm Mr. Kern.
Mr. Kern.
Ven que no dice I am, dice I'm here. I'm. Hi, I'm Paula.
Hi, I'm Paula.
Y luego sigue un punto, ¿verdad? Oh, where, coma, oh, where's Miss Moore?
Where's Miss Moore?
Okay. She's sick today. She's sick today.
Sick today.
Aha. Uh-huh. Try to use the contraction in every word to pronounce it like a contraction. That's why it's a contraction, because it's easier when you speak. Es más rápido cuando hablan. All right. So next part, it's circle the correct words. Use the conversation above to help you. All right. De esta parte vamos a resolver estas cuatro preguntas.
Okay.
Esas preguntas ya las tienen aquí arriba. So, tienen que elegir la correcta. Mm-hmm. Circulando la que ustedes piensen que es conveniente. Tienen, por ejemplo, la uno. Where's? Where the key?
The key.
¿Cuál es la correcta?
Where's?
Where's? So, circulan. Where's the key, right? ¿Por qué? Porque aquí lleva el verbo to be, que es este. Where's the key? Where's the key? Number two. ¿Quién hace la número dos? Who wants to do number two?
Wait up.
Okay, Lupita already said where are,
there are
plural
student test papers.
Why plural? Porque estamos, because we are talking about
the student
test papers. No, we're not talking about, we're not asking about the students. We are asking about the test papers.
Test papers.
When you see, vamos a verlo más adelantito. Cuando you see test paper, quiere decir que los test paper pertenecen a los estudiantes, ¿verdad? Este es un posesivo.
Okay.
I mean, the test papers of the students es lo que significa.
Okay.
Los exámenes de los estudiantes.
Mm-hmm.
Pero en inglés lo ponemos al revés, que se llama posesivo, the students test paper. Anyway, yes. Number three. Katy.
Teachers, what is the teacher's desk?
¿Cuál? ¿La primera?
Es que tengo duda ahí si sería la primera.
Yeah.
No entiendo mucho el apóstrofe.
Right, that's, es lo que vamos a ver en esta lección, el posesivo. Teachers es singular. Right? Después de teachers va la comita, la apóstrofe y va la S, quiere decir que es posesivo.
Okay.
El escritorio del maestro, singular. What is in the teacher's desk? Al poner esta comita aquí arriba y la S, quiere decir que es posesivo, quiere decir que el escritorio, el objeto, pertenece al sujeto.
Uh-huh. O sea,
desk pertenece al maestro, pero estamos hablando de un singular.
Okay.
Pongan mucha atención, pay strictly attention to this because it's very, very important. You know this. Vamos a ir con muchos ejercicios y con más detalles. Esta es la primera pregunta porque me la está haciendo Katy. Teachers, cuando hablamos de sujetos en plural como teachers, aquí estamos hablando de teachers en plural, ¿verdad? Entonces la comita ya no va antes de la S, sino que va después de la S. Como si ustedes checaron aquí, students es plural y la comita viene después, ¿verdad? El apóstrofe viene después. Son los exámenes de los estudiantes. Right?
Mamá.
So, esta pregunta, si nos refiriéramos a los maestros, el escritorio de los maestros, porque no puede ser un escritorio para varios maestros, ¿verdad? What's in the teacher's desk? So, la correcta sería, ¿cuál creen?
The number one, teachers.
Yes, teachers, porque es singular, ¿verdad?
Yes, sí.
Porque es solamente un solo maestro. Recuerden, singular y plural. Dependiendo si es singular o plural, es donde va la comita. Teachers, singular, apóstrofe y la S. Posesivo. Quiere decir que el objeto pertenece al sujeto. Like, por ejemplo, Jesús, last name. Esto se puede usar con cualquier, por ejemplo, nombres. Jesús. Jesús termina en S, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Como termina en S, nada más le ponemos una comita. ¿Qué quiere decir? The last name of Jesus. O sea, para no usar todas esas palabras, que es 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, usamos solamente, en inglés solamente usamos 3, pero tenemos que invertir, ¿verdad? So, Jesús al principio. So, la comita arriba, la apóstrofe, significa que estamos hablando de last name of Jesus. Right? Por ejemplo, Lupita's family. ¿Qué significa?
Okay,
the family of
la familia de Lupita.
De Lupita, right. Recuerden, el primer nombre que ven no es de quien estamos hablando de la familia de Lupita.
De la familia de Lupita.
Ajá. Alejandra's boyfriend. You see? The boyfriend of Alejandra. But we don't say that. The boyfriend of Alejandra is a lot. Es demasiado, too much. Alejandra's boyfriend. Say Acapulco. Acapulco's beaches. You see? Las playas de Acapulco. So we are talking about the beaches of Acapulco. So this could be used with any. Eso se puede, es un posesivo. Right? Por ejemplo, si dimos Miguel's feelings.
Feeling, okay.
Los sentimientos de Miguel. Mexico's. Beauties. Las bellezas de México. Ahora, el punto está aquí en cuando hablamos de plural. Let's see. The buildings, lo ponemos la, really, el apóstrofe va al final, no va como aquí, plural, the buildings, architecture,
las construcciones,
la arquitectura de los edificios. Estamos hablando de los edificios. You see? It's plural. So the apostrophe is at the end. First is the S because it's plural. Right? So what I mean is you cannot do this double. Like the buildings. Like one S because it's plural. And then another S. No, that's wrong.
Yuri, ¿cómo sería la pronunciación de cada uno dependiendo la cómo lleva la tilde?
La pronunciación es la misma.
Sí.
Yeah.
Sí,
just when you write it. Just when you write it, you know what they are talking about. Like the buildings architecture. You don't know if we are talking about plural or singular. All right. Okay. So the last one, let's finish this. I just wanted to make clear un poquito antes de que estamos hablando. So estamos hablando de posesivos, ¿verdad? Ya casi vamos a terminar. Bueno, ya terminamos, son las 10:30. Si alguien se tiene que ir, está bien. So yo me agarro siempre 5 minutos más.
Sí, yo me tengo que ir, teacher, porque tengo que hacer unas cosas.
Ya, el que se tenga que ir, adelante, no hay problema.
Ok, see you next week.
Yeah, see you next week. Have a nice weekend.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, number 4, what's in Mr. Kern or Mr. Kern's pocket?
Mr. Kern's okay. With apostrophe?
Yes, The last one, right? ¿Por qué pues aquí no hay apóstrofe? All right, the next part is the grammar. Es lo que yo les acabo de explicar. Pero aquí lo vamos a hacer con where's. En where, cuando usamos where singular, no estamos hablando de, we are not talking about possessive, no estamos hablando de posesivos, solamente es una contracción, que es where is, right? Where is es para singular. Where is the teacher's desk? Remember, pongan atención en lo último. Aquí van a ver si es singular o es plural. So you need to pick, you need to choose where's, que es la contracción de where is, o where are. Ready?
Yes.
Okay, number one.
Where? Number one or number two?
Number one. No, number two. You have number one already.
Okay. Where are the students' book? Because books is plural.
Right. Jesus?
Where?
Where's?
Where are? Mean?
No, where's o where are. Tienes que escoger una o la otra. Recuerda que estamos hablando de key. Key es singular. It's singular, right?
So, right.
What do you think is where's or where are?
Where's or are?
No, no, you need to pick one. Tienes que elegir una.
Okay.
So la clave te la estoy dando en la última palabra, singular o plural. Singular es where's, que es where is, dónde está, o where are, dónde están.
Es plural.
No, key, where do you see the S? ¿Dónde ves la S?
Singular.
Sí. Yeah, it's singular. So it's
singular.
The answer is
plural.
The answer is where is or where are. Recuerda, where's or where is es para singular. Where are es para plural.
Okay. Where are.
Estamos hablando de key. Key es singular. So la respuesta es where's or where are.
Where are.
No, where is, singular. Where's Mrs. Miss Moore's key?
Where's Miss Moore's.
No confundas el singular con el plural. ¿Dónde está? ¿Dónde están? Si estás hablando de solamente una llave, pues dices, ¿dónde está?
La llave.
La llave de la señora Moore's. No, ¿dónde están? La llave, ¿verdad? No checa. Number four, Lupita.
Where's Mr. Kent's car?
Right. ¿Dónde está la llave? ¿Dónde está el saco? Where's singular? Mr. Kent's car.
Sí, singular.
¿Quién se fue, Alejandra o Katy?
Katy.
Oh, Katy. Alejandra. Hi.
Where's the teacher computer?
Computer. Right. Aquí estamos hablando de teachers, plural. You see?
Where are?
Aquí no estamos hablando de posesivos, como ven aquí. Mr. Kearns Coat, aquí no hay comita, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Pero quieres, aún así, quiere decir, no. Quiere decir que el coat pertenece a Mr. Kern. Teacher's code. Computer tampoco tiene comita. Yes. ¿Ven? Quiere decir que las computadoras son de los maestros.
No, no. De los maestros.
Right. La computadora de los maestros. ¿Una computadora? Maestros. No. La computadora de los maestros.
Maestros.
No, es computadora de los maestros. Aquí no hay ese.
Maestros.
Ajá, aquí sí hay. Entonces es where's the teacher's computer? Porque estamos hablando, el objeto es
de una computadora.
Singular, correcto. Por eso usamos where's singular. No sé, Jesús, si me estoy dando a entender. Jesús.
Yes, teacher, disculpe, me entró una llamada.
Ya. Yeah. Ah, all right. No, I just need to know. Necesito saber si no me estás entendiendo o quieres más explicación. Para, no sé si Lupita y Alejandra tengan claro el tema.
Yes.
Yes.
All right. De todos modos, Jesús, más adelante, cuando tengas tiempo, me mandas un texto y te lo explico.
Okay, yes, teacher.
The same for Lupita o Alejandro o anybody. Si tienen una duda, igual me lo dejan saber y yo les contesto.
Yes, thank you.
Number six, mm-hmm. ¿Quién lo quiere hacer? A ver, Jesús. Where are the students? Workbooks. Recuerda, lo que tenemos que tomar en cuenta es lo último, el objeto. Explorar lo singular. Esta, workbooks.
It's plural,
right? So the same. No estamos tomando en cuenta the students. The students is also plural, right? So the right. Workbooks of the students. So we need where's or where are.
Is where.
Where are the students' workbooks? Remember, where's singular, where are for plural. All right. So let's wrap it up. Terminamos. Seguimos en la siguiente edición. Ok, terminamos y lo dejamos para mañana. Solamente no, do not forget about the homework for today's lesson C, unit 2. Check if you have any questions. Same as I told Jesus. Just give me a text and we will double check again for any questions. Next lesson, we're going to finish give a little explanation about this grammar. ¿Qué es lo que acabamos de hacer? Ya se lo acabo de hacer, lo acabo de... I just say it to you verbally, but it's here. Repasen esta unidad, por favor, Jesús. Remember you have lesson A, B, and C, 3 units.
Okay.
All right.
All
right, guys, thank you so much. See you next Monday, same time. All right, last question. ¿Cómo estuvo la clase? How was the class today?
Good.
Nice teacher.
Yes. Was okay? All right, cool. Thank you so much. Then it's already 10:40. Keep me posted. Let me know. Tell me if you need anything on WhatsApp. All right?
Right.
See you next week. Have a nice weekend. Take care. Okay? Thank you, guys.
Okay, teacher.
See you.
Thanks.
have a nice day.
Bye, teacher.
Thank you. You too. Have a nice week.
Bye, bye, bye.
Bye, bye.